Using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem y double prime plus y equals f of t, and you are given y of 0 equals 0, y prime of 0 equals 1. So here's our f of t. We need to rewrite it in terms of unit step function, because we cannot solve it in terms of as a piecewise function. So it turns out, okay, we're going to start up with 0. Normally I wouldn't write 0, but for the purpose of clarification, I will write it out for you. And then the next function is 1, so we need to have 1, and u is t minus pi. Then the next function is 0, so we need to subtract 1 to get 0, and u of t minus 2 pi, okay? But during this point, I believe you know how to rewrite it in terms of unit step function, so I'm not going to go over it, because this is an initial value problem, so it takes a lot of time. And not go over the unnecessary things, okay? Then this becomes y double prime plus y equals, just bring this over, 1 of u of t minus pi minus 1 of u of t minus 2 pi. Okay, now use the derivative theorem. We have s where capital Y of s minus s y of 0 minus y prime of 0 plus capital Y of s equals e to the negative pi s minus e to the negative 2 pi s, isn't it? Nope. The reason I put number 1 here, because I put it here for the purpose. So normally no one would write 1 times this, right? But a lot of people got this. But it's not the correct answer, because why? Because the Laplace transform is this, it's 1 times u. And it needs to have 1 over s in front, because L of 1 is 1 over s, right? So that's why I put 1 to remind myself that I need to take the Laplace transform of this. Alright, now take a look at the capital Y of s's. And factor out capital Y of s. Then I have s where plus 1 in parentheses. On this side, I have 1 over s e to the negative pi s minus 1 over s e to the negative 2 pi s. Y of 0 equals 0, so this is gone. Y prime of 0 equals 1, so we have negative 1. Move the other side, which is positive 1. Now divide both sides by s squared plus 1. So we have 1 over s times s squared plus 1 e to the negative pi s minus 1 over s times s squared plus 1 e to the negative 2 pi s plus 1 over s squared plus 1. Alright. So the goal is to rewrite this, to write this in fraction forms, right? And you normally use the decomposition method, right? But I can see this and this, I can see that I can use a subcut here, because I want to work with things that complicated and long, okay? I like to work with things that is short, easy, but accurate, okay? So for this one, I'm going to add a step here. I'm going to multiply by s on top and the bottom. So I have s times 1 over s square times s square plus 1 e to the negative pi s. And do the same thing for this one. And rewrite this. Right? Doing this allows me to use a shortcut, because I need to have s square matchup. Okay? By the way, if you haven't had a chance to watch the video that I make about finding the Laplace transform, finding the decomposition partial fraction in less than 30 seconds, I'll put the link in the upper right corner here. Yeah, so you can go there to watch that video. After watching that video, if you don't understand what I'm talking about or not comfortable using it, just ignore it and use whatever method you like, okay? But I refer to using this method because it's short, right? Now, this can be obtained from something over s squared plus something over s squared plus 1, right? And as you can see, they are off by 1. So I'm going to have 1 on top. And next step is to determine which one has the negative sign. As I experienced, the bigger one will carry the negative sign, which is this. So let's check by cross multiply. Negative s squared plus s squared 0, 1 times 1, which is 1, okay? This is what we want. Then on this side, these are exactly the same, so just bring this over. See how easy it is? It just takes you about 5 seconds. Okay, now this will be s. So I have 1 over s minus s over s squared plus 1 e to the negative I s minus 1 over s minus s over s square plus 1 e to the negative 2 pi s plus 1 over s square plus 1. Now, it's ready. We are ready to find a the inverse. So, a inverse of this. So, before I do that, let me work this out first. Right? This is what I have for this one. And in parentheses, 1 over s, his Laplace transform is 1, right? Minus a inverse of this is a cosine of t. But we have the unit step function here, so the t has to match up, which means that we need to have t minus pi to just add it in. Okay? Done with the first term. The second term is similar like this one. Right? 1 over s, 1 minus, so this is still cosine of t. Right? Bracket here. But in this case, it's not t minus pi, why? Because we have e to the negative 2 pi s, so that gives me u of t minus 2 pi, which means that we have t minus 2 pi instead of pi, okay? And the last term is just psi of t, right? So this is your final solution eventually, that's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.